Next on Once a Star, Nate Thurman, Connie Hawkins, and the legends of the NBA.
All right, now it's time for the greatest athletes in the world. Of course, which everyone knows are NBA basketball players. We went down to Dallas over the All-Star weekend, and we talked to some of the greatest who ever played the game of basketball. We wanted to find out what they're doing today.
Typical day is I start off by getting up, going to the exercise class, lift a few weights. Then I might have to take care of my business, which is doing some PR for the Warriors.
But currently I serve as the director of special events for the National Scholarship Service for Negro Students.
I'm living in Pittsburgh right now, and I'm living off my annuities, and if I don't have to travel or go anywhere, I have enough money.
I run Christian basketball camps in the summertime. My main was in Clearwater, Florida. I run one in Atlanta, Georgia, Kenner, Louisiana, probably Houston, Texas this year. And it's expanded.
This year is the first year that I've just kind of taken it easy, kind of laid back, and kind of reassess the direction I like to go. And it's kind of nice to do that sometimes. Because I have been going ever since 1962 on the dead run. I feel good about what Cassie has done. I feel good about myself physically and mentally. I feel great that I had an opportunity to do something that you enjoy and got paid for it. I got a scholarship, got an education by way of it.
People from New York probably saw me at my best. That was when I was learning how to play the game, and I was playing a lot of schoolyard basketball in Harlem. I think a lot of people there saw me at my best. And I think what's happening now, because of the intervention of like the VHRs and all this type of things, if there were some tapes and guys can see some tapes of now and what we've done back then, I think they would be more appreciative of our talents and what we were able to contribute to the game.
Because, see, when I played, you weren't supposed to have pizzazz. You weren't supposed to entertain. You weren't supposed to trick anybody. You weren't supposed, that was considered embarrassing people. I went into Philadelphia one year when I played, back in the early 70s. They had a sign, it was 15 feet high and 30 feet long. It said, Pistol Pete, why do hot dogs cost 15 cents in Philly and $2 million in Atlanta? And that kind of summed up my career.
I always said that the one thing that really charged me up was to hear 15,000 people screaming Nate. And no matter what I do today, that won't happen. So the question is, the biggest high within the NBA.
To be able to take over a game and be influential is a great feeling.
I don't think there's any substitute for that kind of high. I would like to think that the arena of politics, I was privileged to serve as a Senate doorkeeper for the state of Georgia. And I think that provided an era of splendor.
I feel that we are the most recognizable athletes only because of the fact of how much we travel and how tall we are. Now, you can put a very famous, like we're in Dallas, you can put Roger Staubach in an airport. Some people, and a lot of people will recognize him, but not everybody, because he's at everybody else's level. But if Ralph Sampson or Kareem Abdul-Jabbar walks through the Dallas airport, everybody's going to know who they are.
I think the Globetrotters was probably the best experience I've ever had in my life, because of the fact that you talk about education and learning a lot of things. And I traveled around the world twice. And I think if I wasn't with the Globetrotters, I wouldn't be able to learn different languages, different cultural backgrounds, and just learn a lot about things that you read in the history books.
I came from Chicago, a very rough area, very rough neighborhood, where the gangs wanted you to go their way. And I've always been different, so I had to fight for the right to be an individual. I didn't want to join it. I wanted to be my own man.
The public now would think that if you played, that one, you're making a lot of money, and two, that you were involved at some point with the drug situation. We got a high when the ball went through the basket. That was our high.
I've always tried to maintain about the same, you know, kind of persona when I was playing or when I'm not playing. And I'm a pretty easygoing guy, and I try to act in a certain, you know, manner of respect, and that comes from my parents.
I'm glad I don't need this pomp. I don't need all the worldliness that is out there anymore. I'm glad that God chose to save me out of that. See, that's it.
I like to play basketball. You know, I like to get out there and play and make the chips fall where they may.
You know, that technique is embedded. You know, it's there. You love it. You enjoy it. You want to give it to somebody else. That's so it'll continue.
Come on, let's miss again, like we did last summer. Yeah, let's miss again, like we did last year. Do you remember when things were really happening?
Here's my man, Pistol Pete, a pal, who lived off that charisma and pizzazz, and now he's done a 180. It's a guy, when I knew him, God wasn't even in his vocabulary.
I remember Bellamy with the Chicago team. You know, Walter talked to himself all the time out there, pushing up on Walter, goaltending on Walter, palms up on Walter, screening on Walter, always Walter. And Normie Drucker, the referee, one time tapped him on the shoulder and said, tell Walter he just got hit with a technical.
Well, the one thing I don't understand is all these NBA greats in Dallas, and you're not on the floor. And I know you are an NBA great, and I'll prove it to you. Do you know Jack Maron?
Hey, the Fonz a pal. Why?
Well, you made a very big impression on him. Watch this.
I don't remember John Mingo. I don't know who you're talking about. Who did he play for? Did he play? I don't know how you can zing Mangy. I mean, he played as hard as anybody ever saw play the game. So it's really hard. But he had to because he had so little skill.
Jack! Jack's the only guy I know that never had an assist in 11 years in the NBA.